Stephen Bennun here with Israeli News Live. Things are breaking around the world, and some of those events that we're going to be talking about today's broadcast are issues we've been speaking about for years, things that we've been warning you about that is coming. And of course, the Ukraine war, that's not that issue there, but Zelensky doing a retreat after his much-anticipated spring offensive. Already the fears of losing soldiers and pulling back Russians surrounding those soldiers has become a big issue. Hal Turner also reporting about Israeli-made cluster mortar shells being provided to Ukraine. And then one of the things that we had shared with you guys already had done that, I think, over on our Patreon channel, may have done that on a regular broadcast as well. 97 U.S. NATO Special Operation Forces already inside Ukraine operating, but not just inside of Ukraine, but inside of Russia as well. So there you have it there. He's speaking about that. We're going to be looking at the New World Order, the BRICS nations. And I have said this for years, that BRICS is your New World Order. Israel, the Jewish leaders around the world, since the late 80s, early 90s, were moving all of their big manufacturing jobs from America over to China, Taiwan, places like that, building up this huge New World Order. So when BRICS came out, it was nothing new. All right, let's get right into what's going on in the news today, though. Zelensky has issued a retreat order, is saying he's going to issue a retreat order while he was with the Polish leader today. Said his troops in the eastern city of Bukomut, if they found themselves in a danger being encircled by Russian forces. He says, for me, the most important is not to lose our soldiers. And of course, if there is a moment of even hotter events and danger, we could lose our personnel because of encirclement. Of course, the corresponding correction decisions will be taken by generals there, Zelensky said during a news conference in Poland on Wednesday alongside his Polish counterpart. Well, of course, he hasn't really thought that highly of his own soldiers there when his own military was kidnapping men of able-bodied fighting age and taking them to the front lines, dropping them off with an AK-47 and nothing else, and basically fend for your life with no training. That was information we'd gotten directly out of Ukraine, things happening along those lines there. And then also, like I said, we have this where Hal Turner has been reporting several things there, showing also Israeli-made, these mortar shells that are cluster bombs there that are being supplied to Ukraine. Said Israel has been caught red-handed supplying deadly cluster munitions to Ukraine for the use against Russian forces. Despite the fact that Israel says it does not supply weapons and ammunition to Ukraine, it turns out that Israel Defense Forces have transferred a large batch of 120-millimeter mortar ammunition to Ukraine. Apart from the fact that such ammunition has a high destructive power, it turned out that the ammunition in question is M971, which is a cluster munition that not only causes serious destruction, but also poses an additional threat of landmines. This is not the first time the Israeli side has supplied such munitions to Ukraine. So, just amazing how things go, right? It's always something there. And of course, Hal had put out several of these here as well, showing NATO's involvement inside of the country there. It wasn't anything we didn't already know about, and nothing that we hadn't already reported to you guys, especially the special forces operating in behind enemy lines. A couple of months ago, we'd brought this to your attention, actually specifically inside of Russia. Putin knows very well that they're doing this, nothing new under the sun, so to speak. Ava, I cannot pronounce her last name there, is reporting over on Twitter that 130 missiles from Lebanon have been launched into Israel. Some 80% of those have been intercepted by Israeli David Sling, and of course, U.S. Patriot batteries that are intercepting those up in northern Israel. I also got a message from a friend of mine in FEMA that the UN peacekeepers have been ordered to their bomb shelters. That's another thing that is happening there. So the situation is getting very, very serious. They're also, Israel is saying that they're anticipating more than one front that is going to heat up for them the very near future, trying to warn their own population just about how serious those issues are. And by the way, before I go much further in this broadcast, I do want to thank Charles on Twitter, as well as Rosa, for some of the broadcast links that I have here, sharing those with us there. They do an amazing job at bringing out more information. This video here, again, the second time in a row that the Israeli forces have stormed the Al-Aqsa Mosque over on the Temple Mount. Also, video posted online shows the scene, not only creating a lot of fear, but also it has sparked the Jordanian minister to require a special meeting with Israel of these continued incursions that are happening up on the Temple Mount. Now, of course, Israel has said that there was youth that have been throwing firecrackers and things like that of the visitors that were coming up and then using the Al-Aqsa Mosque to hide out. There was some 300 arrests that were made. And of course, there's, you know, always something going on there. And it just seems like this violence is not going to stop. Is just going to increase as we see on a regular basis there. This came from Charles here. O'Neill urges BRICS bloc to expand challenge dollars dominance. Jim O'Neill. Wow, what is Jim O'Neill up to here? The former Goldman Sachs Group Incorporated chief economist who coined the acronym BRIC, B-R-I-C. Later, when South Africa joined, it became the BRICS nations. And this is when we begin to report this clearly would be, I'll call it a one world government agenda, because I notice that no matter what videos that I put out, if you got NWO written on there or even say the word New World Order, then immediately Wikipedia come out and says that it's all a conspiracy theory. Well, it's not so much a conspiracy theory. And the very fact that this man here, Jim O'Neill, is calling for the collapse of the dollar, basically, and expanding on this BRICS bloc for all other nations to join in, which we are seeing that happen. We're seeing that. We've seen Saudi Arabia, we've seen Egypt, now Mexico is talking about joining the BRICS nations, and just one nation after another is coming on board, and they're looking to break up the hegemony of the U.S. dollar. So all of this is certainly falling in line. It's falling in line because we talked about the Silk Road Initiative, and after all, even though we could say the wealthy elite of the world, like the Rothschilds, etc., are very much behind the IMF, International Monetary Fund, the global dollar, the dominance of the U.S. dollar, but now they're trying to collapse it because basically they've already bankrupted that particular financial institution, so they're creating a new one. And this is why you saw so many companies move over to China, Taiwan, places like that in the Far East there, doing their manufacturing there, not just for a cheaper product, but also because that's going to be part of the Silk Road Initiative, the one world, the new one world order, you might say. And just to prove that point here, the Washington Examiner, and again, Charles sent me this one here. I really appreciate that, Charles, for you doing that. New world order will compensate for Russia's losses in Ukraine. Well, how come Wikipedia hasn't put a thing on here on the Washington Examiner? Interesting, right? Look what was said, stated here by Putin right here in the very beginning. Russian invasion of Ukraine will accelerate the inauguration of a new world order based on law and justice, in which economic and political gains will justify the losses sustained thus far, according to the Russian President Vladimir Putin. Oh, wow. I thought people were saying that Vladimir Putin was fighting the new world order. And I've been telling you all along, nope. He is playing his part to establish a new world order. So I'm going to be really getting into that this weekend and go very deep into this, but I want to share some of the thoughts here that he says. What is happening undoubtedly in the end, I emphasize that in the end, we benefit Russia and its future. Why is that? Because it will help reinforce our sovereignty in all domains, and in particular, the economic field. Wow, Putin ally urges Russia's Chechen Muslims to start jihad attacks in Europe. That's another interesting scenario that's going on. If you remember back during the time when the Syrian conflict was happening and all the refugees were fleeing, not just Syria, but Turkey and other countries, and even coming out of South or out of Africa, all fleeing into Europe and then settling in Europe, I said that that would be part of the destabilization of Western Europe in order to cause the collapse of that society to get rid of all the NATO bloc countries. I told you this, guys, 4 or 5 years ago. All of that was going to be coming. Now we're starting to see it. They're calling for jihad attacks in Europe. Destabilization. They're going to break NATO from within, including the United States. So you know, we got to put on our seatbelt, get ready, because it is definitely coming. Here is the U.S. Secretary of State. Sweden will join NATO. We're seeing Finland has joined NATO already. That's causing a major problem. Now they're talking about Sweden joining NATO. So let me take you over here to where he's talking about this here. Listen in.
As well as partners in Asia. There is concern that were there to be a crisis as a result of China's actions over Taiwan, that would have repercussions for quite literally every country on Earth. 50% of commercial traffic, 50% of global commercial traffic goes through the Taiwan Strait every day. 70% of the semiconductors that we need for our smartphones, for our dishwashers, for our cars, they're made on Taiwan. If there was some kind of crisis as a result of something that that China did, that would have terribly disruptive effects on the global economy.
The full interview will be on air.
There you go. There you go. We also told you about that as well, that if Taiwan collapses, it would be a devastation on U.S. economy. Well, Taiwan is not really going to collapse. China's just going to take it over because China needs the boost. China's going to be the head of the New World Order as far as military power. And they will basically take the place of the United States. And that's another thing. I've been also getting reports as well that there is a move of Russian forces in the far east of Syria. They've also requested access to Iraqi airspace and are planning on pushing the United States out of the Middle East. This is something we've also been telling you for quite some time. Now, jumping into some of these things that I've told you about before, here we go right here, this video here, why the U.S. and Israel want regime change in Iran, China's Silk Road. This is from, what year is this here that I did this here on? Oh, gosh, 4 years ago, at least you go back 4 years. That's for the China Silk Road. I talked about in there from intel that I had right out of Iran, that the collapse of Iran is important because that is one of the main countries where the Chinese railroad track goes through. They need to be able to control that, as well as the seven nations that General Wesley Clark talked about collapsing, including those in northern Africa. All those are important nations because it's part of that Silk Road One World system that they're putting together. You have here China and Russia take top take a top spot in the NWO. Oh, wow. What do you know? The BRICS nations. All right. Here's another one. NATO threatens Putin in a struggle for a new world order dominance. And that is what it comes down to it. Who's going to rule the world? Now, the thing is, whether or not the politicians know it or not doesn't make any difference. The elite behind the scene know exactly which direction they want to take this and how they're going to bring about this NWO in the first place. And again, no new NWO covert plan to suppress your DNA. I got to go back and look at that one again there. I forgot about what that was about, but I will definitely be updating myself on a lot of this information and sharing that with you guys in the very near future. I'm Stephen Bennun. You're watching Israeli News Live. And, oh, wait a minute, there is, oh, there were a couple other things too. Yeah, this was kind of funny from Vanessa Bealey. She posts here, Emmanuel Macron coming into China, no one meeting him there, only the guy that opened the airplane door was the guy that met him at the airport. I thought that was kind of cute. Vanessa does a great job on that one there. Let's see here. Oh, also too, Wall Street Journal, decentralization, cryptocurrency markets threaten U.S. national security, Treasury says. By the way, it is those banks that collapsed were the ones that were behind the cryptocurrency or support of cryptocurrency. It's not that the U.S. government is against cryptocurrency. The NWO will be a cryptocurrency system. It is because what they want to do is make sure they control it. And that's another thing I've shared with you on our Patreon channel. Definitely check out our Patreon channel. We uploaded a new video there a few days ago. We'll be doing more here in the very near future. So maybe, in fact, this weekend I'll be uploading more videos there. And it's also another way you can be supportive of our broadcast. So we really do appreciate you. Thank you for that. Also, IsraeliNewsLive.org. You can support us there online just by clicking here online. It's the fastest way. And, of course, by mail, Bennun Institute, P.O. Box 156, Sunbright, Tennessee 37872. Thank you, and thank you for your kindness. I've also been trying to answer the people that donate online as well, thanking you there, as well as by mail. And, again, be putting together another letter here to send out, almost kind of like a little newsletter as well. I like to try to encourage not just thank you, but to be of encouragement as well to you. God bless you. in a world that is so chaotic. I'm Stephen Bennun with Israeli News Live.